As noted earlier in the film, the Lancraft Fife and Drum Corps was organized in 1888 in New Haven on the banks of the Quinnipiac River, I should say, and practiced in a variety of locations. And early on, at one point, an oyster captain by the name of Ed Lancraft, Lone Lancraft, the use of a little oyster shed, of which we have pictures of our drums sitting on the deck, for some years. At times when finances were a little low, Mr. Lancraft loaned some money. He paid for several sets of uniforms and purchased the instruments, mostly the drums, which are the greatest expense at that time. The Lancraft continued in several other locations in New Haven, and changed to the present uniform, which is called the Continental uniform, in about 1909. We have excellent records of early minutes before 1900, and our list of our charter members, famous old New Haven names. At one point, Lancraft was called the Oyster Keg Corps because there were oyster kegs kicking around the oyster house, and our drums, first set of drums, looked like oyster kegs. Incidentally, we still have those four shells of those drums, and by today's standards, they are very heavy. The Lancraft members built the present clubhouse here in North Haven on Clark Avenue about 1961-62, into which we moved our thousands of mementos, which include hundreds of pictures scattered along these walls. It includes upwards of 1,000 trophies, even though many were lost in a fire some years ago, and other possessions valuable to Lancraft. The members of this corps come from 19 Connecticut towns, Massachusetts, New York, and we have three honorary members from Switzerland. These men practice here every Thursday night, the year round, except for holidays. Anytime after 8 o'clock, you will find us here, and visitors are welcome. We schedule approximately 15 parade events a year, which consists of anniversary parades in a variety of towns in Connecticut, some out of state, and usually two or three musters, major musters, such as Westbrook and Deep River, and Sudbury, Massachusetts, at the famous Longfellow's Wayside Inn. We have officers to run the business affairs of the Corps, 9 officers for that purpose, and we have 7 line officers consisting of drum major, color sergeant, drum sergeant, fife sergeant, and corporals of the three instruments. Our accomplishments of the members and the Corps are very, very numerous. This drum corps has won a great number of state championships for playing. It has won some Northeastern States championships for corps playing. Our individual members have won dozens of championships on the snare drum, the bass drum, and on the fife. These members are still active, most of them, and we see them, those that are semi-retired or still in the area, each year at our annual Old Timers Night, held on the last Thursday of every April. At this time, we gather and invite key members from many drum corps and honor our own retired members or visitors from distant points. We award usually two Man of the Year awards at that point. Our instruments are well known to the fife and drum world, consisting of a wooden fife with six finger holes and nothing else but a cork in one end. It is played over two octaves, and you would be amazed at the kind of music that comes out of this simple instrument as you hear the music during the parade and on the field. The snare drum is a rope tension drum, quite large by snare drum standards, but and averaging almost 2 feet in depth. These drums weigh about 9 pounds and have calfskin head and batter head. They are more difficult to play and than the short drums you see in modern drum and bugle corps. As a matter of fact, the longer the drum, the longer it takes to fill up with sound, and it makes it more difficult to play the standard beat of 110 to the minute, which is a normal cadence for most fife and drum corps. I would like to introduce Drum Sergeant Hugh F. Quigley, who has been a member of Lancraft since 1941. After playing 7 to 8 years with the St. Francis Parochial School Fifes and Drums, where he originally started his drum training under the great instructor Earl Sturtz. Hugh Quigley has won 6 state championships, as many Northeastern States championships, and 2 national open championships on the snare drum. In the last 2 years, he has been inducted into the Drum Corps Hall of Fame in Allentown, Pennsylvania in 1987. And this past week, he was inducted into the Drummers Association Hall of Fame in New Jersey. It is with great honor that we introduce Hugh Quigley to play as a drum demonstration after we get through with Yankee Doodle Together.
Thank you.
the town of North Haven some years ago, a well-known resident named Alice McMullen had organized the North Haven Schools Fife, Drum, and Bugle Corps. At one time, they had a great number of members, and today I assume that many of them are still living in the area or in North Haven. Lancraft Fife and Drum Corps cordially invites young men interested in fifing or even in the color guard to come down any Thursday night after 8 o'clock to watch our rehearsals or to inquire about possible instruction and perhaps membership in this drum corps. We need young men to fill the aging ranks of our members who probably average in the vicinity of 55 years of age at present. Our members do range from 30 to 72 years old, and most of them are very active on parades and in the activities of the corps, which also include a number of social events during the year. We include our wives in many functions, and they often travel on these parade trips, especially out of state, or if you choose, perhaps Switzerland one day again. So we extend this invitation wholeheartedly and hope to see any young man interested in Lancraft Fife and Drum Corps right here in the hometown of North Haven, Connecticut. Many thanks for listening to this presentation.